Welcome to our user-friendly CT meter installation guide. In this simple step-by-step tutorial, we will guide you through the process of installing a CT meter. The video consists of three essential steps. Step 1 focuses on safety precautions. Step 2 delves into understanding the circuit diagram. And step 3 involves final checks and power restoration. Safety precautions. In this video, we have divided safety precautions into 4 parts. Let's take a look at each of them. A. Initiating work. B. Circuit work safety. C. Personal protective equipment, PPE. D. Promoting safety and efficiency. Now, let's delve into a detailed explanation of each of the 4 parts of safety precautions. A. Initiating work. This section focuses on the crucial steps to take before beginning any task. It emphasizes the importance of conducting a comprehensive assessment of the work area to identify potential hazards. This includes the work area must be organized and kept clean. Sufficient lighting should be ensured in the workspace. It is crucial to treat all voltage levels as equally hazardous, even those that may not cause electric shocks. Before undertaking any repair, maintenance, or other tasks, it is imperative to verify that the circuit is completely inactive. B. Circuit work safety. Working with electrical circuits requires specific precautions to minimize the risk of electric shock or other electrical hazards. This section highlights the need to identify and switch off power sources before initiating any work on the circuit. It emphasizes the importance of using insulated tools to prevent electrical contact and stresses the significance of following proper lockout, TAGU procedures to isolate the circuit from the power source. Adhering to these measures helps prevent accidental energization and reduces the likelihood of electrical accidents. C. Personal protective equipment, PPE. This section emphasizes the importance of wearing appropriate personal protective equipment to minimize the risk of injuries or exposure to hazardous substances. It highlights the various types of PPE that should be utilized depending on the nature of the task and the potential hazards involved. This includes safety glasses or goggles to protect the eyes, gloves to shield the hands, hard hats to protect the head, and specialized clothing or respiratory equipment as needed. It stresses the necessity of using PPE consistently and correctly to ensure maximum safety. D. Promoting safety and efficiency. This section emphasizes the importance of fostering a safety-conscious work environment. It encourages the establishment of a culture where safety is given high priority and individuals are encouraged to actively participate in maintaining a safe workplace. Regular safety training sessions are recommended to keep employees updated on best practices and to raise awareness about potential risks. It emphasizes the significance of open communication, where team members can freely express safety concerns and suggestions for improvement. Promptly addressing any safety concerns and implementing necessary measures further enhances safety and efficiency in the workplace. By understanding and implementing these detailed explanations of the 4 parts of safety precautions, individuals and teams can work more confidently, minimize risks, and create a safer working environment for everyone involved. Understanding the circuit diagram. In this part of this video, we will provide a detailed description of the CT meter installation process. We will explain the circuit diagram and the connection of various components, including a 200 kVA transformer, 400 ampere MCCB, fuse box, 3 400 to 5 CTs, a neutral link, and an earth link. We will also discuss the purpose and function of each component in the installation. Transformer connection. We start by connecting the three-phase 11 kV line to the HT side of a 200 kVA transformer. The transformer acts as a step-down device, reducing the high voltage from the power source to a lower voltage suitable for consumption. MCCB and Distribution Board. The output of the transformer, represented by three phases, L1, L2, and L3, is connected to a 400 AMCCB. The MCCB serves as a switch and overcurrent protection device for the installation. From the MCCB, the power is distributed to the distribution board or load. Transformer neutral and earthing. The neutral point of the transformer is connected to the earth through an earthing cable. This connection ensures proper grounding and safety by redirecting any fault currents to the ground. Additionally, a neutral wire from the neutral point connects to the neutral link, ensuring a balanced load across the three phases. Current transformers, CTs. CTs are used to measure the current flowing through the circuit accurately. In this installation, we have 3 400 to 5 CTs. CTs have two sides, S1 and S2. It is essential to orient them correctly, ensuring that the side marked K1, P1, or H1 faces the supply incoming direction. Each phase, R, Y, and B, passes through its respective CT before reaching the distribution board or load. Power circuit completion. The L1 phase from the output of the 400 AMCCB passes through the first CT, CT1, and then proceeds to the distribution board or load. Similarly, the blue, B, and yellow, Y, phases pass through the second and third CTs, respectively, before reaching the distribution board or load. A neutral wire from the neutral link connects to the load, ensuring a complete power circuit. CT meter connection. To measure the current accurately, we connect the phases, R, Y, and B, from the output side of the MCCB to a three-way fuse box. Each phase passes through a 5A fuse for safety purposes. Inside the CT meter cover, a 10-way terminal block is present for connections. Here is the step-by-step connection process for the CT meter. The wire from the S1 terminal of CT1 is connected to the first terminal of the CT meter. The second terminal of the CT meter is connected to the R phase, which passes through a 5 ampere fuse. The second terminal of CT1 is connected to the third terminal of the CT meter. The first terminal of CT2 is connected to the fourth terminal of the CT meter. The Y phase is connected to the fifth terminal of the CT meter, passing through a 5 ampere fuse. The second terminal of CT2 is connected to the sixth terminal of the CT meter. The first terminal of CT3 is connected to the seventh terminal of the CT meter. The B phase is connected to the eighth terminal of the CT meter, passing through a 5 ampere fuse. The second terminal of CT3 is connected to the ninth terminal of the CT meter. A neutral wire from the neutral link is connected to the 10th terminal of the CT meter. Earth connection. An earth wire is connected from the earthing point to the earth link. Another wire is connected from the earth link to the second terminal, S2, of CT1. This same wire is then looped to the second terminals, S2, of CT2 and CT3. This connection ensures proper grounding and safety by diverting any fault currents to the earth. Step 3. Final checks and power restoration. Now that we have completed the previous steps, it's time to perform some final checks and restore power to the CT meter supply. This step is important to ensure that everything is working correctly and the power supply is functioning as expected. First, double-check all the connections and wires to ensure they are properly secured and in the right place. Make sure there are no loose or damaged wires that could cause any issues. Next, inspect the CT meter supply unit for any signs of damage or malfunction. If you notice anything out of the ordinary, it's important to address it before proceeding. Once you have confirmed that all the connections are secure and the CT meter supply unit is in good condition, it's time to sell all three CT, the fuse box and CT meter. After sealing all the above, restore the power. Follow the manufacturer's instructions or standard procedures for turning on the power supply. As the power is restored, monitor the CT meter supply unit closely to ensure it powers up without any issues. Pay attention to any error messages or warning lights that may appear. If you notice any problems, it's important to take immediate action and consult with a qualified professional if needed. Once the power is successfully restored and everything appears to be functioning properly, you can consider this step complete. However, it's always a good idea to continue monitoring the CT meter supply unit for a period of time to ensure there are no hidden issues or intermittent problems. Remember, safety is paramount throughout this process. If you are unsure about any step or encounter any difficulties, it's best to seek assistance from a knowledgeable person or consult with a professional to avoid any potential risks. We hope this detailed guide and circuit diagram explanation have been helpful in demystifying CT meter installation for you. If you have any questions or need further assistance, please leave a comment below, and we'll be happy to help. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel for more informative content, and hit the notification bell to stay updated with our latest uploads. Thank you for watching, and happy CT meter installation.